Hi everyone and welcome back. In this video we are going to talk about another problem which is also popular, which is odometer. So you see these kind of odometers are in there in the bike and scooty, which shows you the kilometer reading. Okay, so like so there can be a question, okay, that your current reading in the odometer for your bike is 450 kilometer. And you have to find out how many times the number has shown, number is shown by your odometer, like number is 4. Okay, so how many times 4 occurs or 4 appeared in your odometer screen while recording these 250 kilometer in your odometer. Okay, it's the same standard problem. It can be as simple as, okay, you have like sequence from 1, 2, 3 up to 500, and you have to find out how many times the element 4 is occurring. They give us the count, return the count of 4 which is occurring in this sequence. Same, we just replaced it with the odometer, right? So what we need to do is we have to just write a function. We have to iterate, to first iterate this I from 1 to 250, and for every iteration we have to check that the required digit is available in that or not. Okay, consider that when there is a single digit number, that is fine. Okay, we can just check. But what about like when you have a 55 or 100? In that case, how you will check that this particular digit exists in this number or not, right? Like 5 exists, that is true. 5 exists here, that is true. But what about 40? What about 45? How you will check that 5 exists? So for that particular case, what we will do is we will write a function odometer. It will take, consider that we are taking number as an argument. It can be simple num. Okay, and const count, which is initialized with 0. It should be let, not const, because we will keep updating this. This is initialized with 0. Okay, and we are going to run a loop. Let I is 0. I is less than number which we got, and I plus plus, and here we will check. So here we will just check that digit exists or not. Digit exist, and we just need to pass I here. If that digit exists, we can avoid using var keyword. If that exists, we can just increase the count. Okay, and we just need to return the count. Finally, this is our objective, return count, right? Now we just need to find this method, write this method here. Find if this particular digit exists. Okay, and what we are doing is we are taking the number. This number we are taking as an input. Okay, and let digit 2 find. Okay, let's say I wanted to find digit 4. So I will just run a loop. So this is a standard problem where you actually do the modulus and divide by 10 to get the number. So if this number not equal to 0, till then run this loop. And in this loop, what you will do is let digit equal to this number modulus 10. Okay, and this number equal to math dot floor, this number divided by 10. If now what we will say, if this number, or sorry, this digit, it's simply a digit we have, if digit equal to the number we need to find, digit to find, if this is same, we will return true. otherwise we will return false. So we did a modulus, so if we get a number, like let's say we got a number 45, okay, digit modulus 10, so we will get 5. After dividing it with the 10, we will get digit is now 5. If 5 is digit to find, now 5 divided by 10, that will be this number, it will be 0, so it will run a loop till that time, but 5 not equal to the digit we wanted to found, okay. So it will return in the 45 digit to find 4, so it will return true for that particular number. Okay, so similarly, it will just increase this counter whenever in a particular digit it is able to find that. Okay, first we are doing a modulus. Okay, modulus will give us the remainder. Okay, and then we are doing a divided by and math.floor, so we can get at least 0 in not a float value. So if it in this first occurrence it will become 0, so this is how we will run the condition and we will return true. Okay, so this increment, this count, whatever the count we are getting, that will be the count that particular variable is occurring in the series of those set of numbers. Okay, that's it. In the next video, we'll just talk about some generic set of questions. I think I will not be extending this series a lot, where because there are many set of videos, many set of questions we can talk about. Now I will be moving next to the primary set of questions being asked from Node.js, React, Angular, Vue.js, vanilla JavaScript and all these things. Okay, thanks everyone.